Live, local breaking news. This is WYFF News 4 at 6 in high definition.
'Twas the night before Christmas, and all through the South, rain, cold, and miserable conditions.
As you can see here, it will be a soggy night for church services and family gatherings, and it's really not going to get much better for the big day tomorrow. Chief Meteorologist John Sesrich is tracking this rainy weather. He joins us now. So, more rain tomorrow, John?
Yeah, no white Christmas. We've been talking about it for about a week and a half now, Gabrielle and Nigel. Looks like it's going to be all liquid precipitation, but for the most part on Christmas Day, it's going to really be cloudy with areas of fog, and some of the fog actually could form overnight tonight and early tomorrow morning, so watch out for that. Some of that fog could get really, really thick, but don't worry about it. You know, the red nose on Rudolph will go right through that fog, so we'll have no problems with Santa getting here late tonight and tomorrow morning for you kids in the western Carolinas and northeastern Georgia. The big batch of rain, the one storm system moved through, brought us some good soaking rains, now has shifted off to our east, so now we're just clouds with some areas of fog beginning to form across the area. As I mentioned, it could get pretty thick and a few patches of drizzle, but that rain that moved through, beneficial rains for us, even though a lot of you were doing some last-minute Christmas shopping, it was tough out there with all this rain coming down, but we needed the rain badly. Almost 1 inch of rain fell in Greenville, Spartanburg, a little over a half inch of rain in Anderson, and a little bit over 0.3 inch of rain officially at the Asheville Regional Airport. We'll talk more about Christmas Day forecast and look ahead to the weekend a little bit later on. Now back to you, Gabrielle.
All right, thank you, John. Now, this wet weather is much needed in the upstate because of the drought. We are around 10 inches below where we should be in terms of rainfall for this time of year. But the rain is not so good for those last-minute holiday travelers. News 4's Mandy Gaither is live and local in our Anderson newsroom tonight. And Mandy, AAA is projecting busy roads.
Through January 1st, when the holiday ends, they say 1.1 million drivers will take to the roadways between past Saturday through New Year's. And the extra cars makes this holiday, unfortunately, one of the deadliest of the year. And the rain isn't helping.
Driving on the interstate over the busy holiday isn't ever easy, but add some rain to the mix and it gets downright hard.
It's a very bad situation. The roads are slick. You really can't navigate your way around. You really can't see when it gets real thick.
Traveling for 2 days, Ed Johnston says the wet weather is beginning to get to him.
All this rain dampening your holiday spirit at all?
Yeah. It is to a certain extent. I'm not in the festive, joyous mood anymore. I just want to get there.
According to AAA Carolinas, nearly 1.3 million South Carolinians are expected to travel more than 50 miles from home over the 11-day holiday, which started Saturday.
We're taking it slow. That's the best thing we can do right now.
Decreasing gas prices is one of the reasons AAA Carolinas says more people are driving this holiday.
We just got to avoid all the traffic. We can avoid all the storms because it's scary.
Daylight, thank goodness, because if it were nighttime and all that rain, it would be really bad.
With rain landing like Christmas lights on trees, perhaps there's a silver lining in all the rain.
I've been in Florida for the last 4 years, so I'm not used to having a white Christmas. Seeing a wet Christmas is just as good, I guess.
And AAA Carolinas also says gas prices are expected to stabilize or go down even further throughout the holiday due to lower demand and high inventories. Mandy Gaither, WYFF News 4, live in the Anderson newsroom.
Mandy, thank you. It happened again. Someone online got into yet another state agency. First, it was the State Department of Revenue. Now, it's the State Department of Employment and Workforce. This time, the damage, we are told, was minor. However, that may not be the case.
Department of Employment and Workforce representatives said a malicious user replaced the main page of the website with a message. However, officials want to make it clear the website was not hacked. But how can the state be sure? That is what we asked Bobby Schmidt with Servosity in Greenville.
That means that they had access to it, and that's what's scary, is the fact that they either had some sort of access to that website, and unfortunately the same kind of access that somebody had for the tax information is the fact that they had someone's information to log on.
In other words, Schmidt, who helps run the Greenville-based internet security company, fears unless the state takes measures to protect itself, it could happen again, and soon.
I went to a security conference a couple years ago, and they said people in Eastern Europe are sitting there learning how to hack into our systems while we're playing sports in high school. You know, that's a lot of ways that there's a lot of income that can be made that way, sadly.
Even State Senator Kevin Bryant, who is on the Labor, Commerce, and Industry Committee, said it's hard for him to believe that more damage was not done by the user.
Now, South Carolina taxpayers have two more months to sign up for a state-paid credit monitoring service following the largest security breach in state history. Governor Haley has extended the deadline to March 31st now. The state is paying Experian $12 million for 1 year of credit monitoring services. Nearly 1 million people have signed up so far.
The Highway Patrol will decide whether to file charges in connection with a deadly accident in Greenville County. The coroner says Roy James Crane was hit and killed while he was walking on Woodside Avenue. The accident happened just before 8 last night between Bramlett and Parker Roads. The coroner says Crane had been visiting friends and was walking to his home on City View Street. The case is still under investigation, awaiting toxicology results. A westbound lane of I-40 near the Tennessee line is back open after a weekend rock slide. The slide shut down the busy road Friday night. 3 dump truck loads worth of rocks fell onto the shoulder of I-40 in Waynesville. Workers quickly removed the rubble from inside the lane. And again, the North Carolina DOT says the interstate is open and traffic is now clear in that area.
Remember all that windy weather we had last week? Well, that weather set a record at Grandfather Mountain in North Carolina. Here is the view of the popular Mile High Swinging Bridge, where officials say the wind gusted to 120.7 miles per hour for 3 seconds last Friday. That broke the record 3-second gust of 114.7 miles per hour that was set back on January 26th of 2011. The wind gust was part of a low-pressure system that brought widespread winds, I love when I can talk like John, above 50 miles per hour to much of the North Carolina mountains, causing power outages and knocking down trees. Observers have been recording the weather for nearly 6 decades at this spot. Uh-oh, time is up. If you have not finished all of your Christmas shopping, there are very few places left to do it now. All of the major malls, including Haywood Mall in Greenville, closed up shop at 6 o'clock.
Before those doors closed, though, thousands did hit the malls, making their last dash for gifts. News 4's Sean Mazzarella tells us the reason some of them waited so long.
30 years.
It's tradition. That's Sharon O'Connor's excuse for being out shopping on Christmas Eve.
I find little things that they want and little surprises.
There are millions of shoppers like her who are not quite done when they woke up on Christmas Eve. 17 million people, in fact, who cut it close by hitting stores late in the game. Retailers are making it easy to procrastinate. Many stores like Target, Toys R Us, and Macy's stayed open around the clock this weekend and through Christmas Eve. Ernest Piles Jr. had 15 relatives to shop for and only a few hours to get it done. He says he's usually rewarded at the register for waiting.
A lot of them got good deals, so you save money.
Retail analysts say sales this holiday season are on track to top $586 billion, the most optimistic forecast since recession. And these last-minute shoppers will only add to that total. Sean Mazzarello, WYFF News 4, Greenville.
And if you're still looking for a way to give, the Holiday Sunshine Fund is still open. WYFF 4 is once again teaming up with the Greenville News to raise money for organizations that help your neighbors in need. Today, we collected $5,623, bringing our grand total to more than $65,700. That is amazing. And there is still time for you to help. You can send a donation to P.O. Box 1688, Greenville, South Carolina, 29602, or just log on to WYFF4.com and look for the Holiday Sunshine Fund on our homepage.